are two competitions, one for kindergarten and second grade through second grade, and one through third and fifth graders.
You might be thinking, when is the all-school movie day? Well, the all-school movie day will be in March, the Friday before spring break. Now, an interview for Isaiah.
Hi, today I'm going to be interviewing Ms. Sansoni.
Hi.
So my first question I have for you, where have you lived? Where have you lived and the places that you've been to?
Where have I lived? Well, so I was born in Oak Park, Illinois, so I've lived mostly in Illinois. I've lived in Arlington Heights, Carroll Stream, actually for 6 months lived in Madrid, Spain when I studied there.
Mm-hmm.
For about 6 months I studied there my junior year of college. Yeah, so I was in Madrid, Spain, so that was neat.
So are those all the places that you've been to, or just the places that you've lived?
No, just the places that I've lived. So, but yeah, I've visited other places as well.
Mm-hmm. If you can learn a different language, what language would you learn and why?
Ooh, well, in college, my degree was actually in languages. I Spanish and French, so I speak Spanish and French and English. So if I could learn another one, maybe Italian or maybe Japanese. I don't know. Any language. Languages are great.
They're fun to speak.
Mm-hmm, they are.
When you went to college, what did you major in?
Oh, like I told you, languages. Yes, Spanish and French. I got my degree in languages.
Mm-hmm. Do you remember your grade teachers in elementary school?
Oh, yeah, I sure do. You want to know their names? Sure. One of my favorite teachers in elementary school was Mr. Satterley. He taught, I had him for fourth grade and I had him for fifth grade. He taught me how to play chess. He would wear this Mickey Mouse tie and it had 204 Mickey Mice all over him. Isn't that funny? Like, it's the funny things you remember. And we had treat days on Friday.
Do you remember what school it was?
Yes, I went to Americana Elementary.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know that school? It is in Glendale Heights. That's so funny to know. How do you do family and friends there? Okay, now I'm interviewing you.
No, I'm from friends.
Oh, okay, from friends. Yeah.
Since you like teaching at the school, mm-hmm. do you have a side job to make extra cash?
You know what? This is what Sansoni does. Sometimes, and I find it especially during finals or in the summer, Mrs. Sansoni will help tutor high school kids with Spanish.
That's cool.
Yeah, I like it.
Do you like teaching English as a second language?
Sure, I love it. That's what I went to school for. Yeah, I just love working with all different kinds of students, you know, everybody.
So that's the end of my interview. Okay. Thanks, Chris Sansoni.
Oh, thanks, Isaiah. I enjoyed our time together.
Thanks, Isaiah. That was a good interview.
Now, a weather report from Gabby.
Hey, Huskies. I'm Gabby, the meteorologist. Today's weather will be a wintry mix, so that means rain and snow. Wind mile is 6, temperature is 33, so bundle up so you won't be cold. This week's weather will be cloudy, partly cloudy, and sunny, with the lows of 30s and 40s. Now I have a weather illustration for today's weather. I don't know if you'll see it, but there. This weekend's weather will be sunny and cloudy. That's the weather for this week, Huskies.
Thanks, Gabby. That was great.
Now a book report from Emma, who is reading Aiden's and one of her own.
My book is Fish in a Tree. Fish in a Tree is a realistic fiction book. The characters that you will be able to mostly step into their lives and know them the most are Allie, Mr. Daniels, Albert, and Keisha. I love this book because it tells an amazing story, an inspiring story, of a girl who has to overcome a challenge. I also thought that Mr. Daniels was extremely inspiring. In this book, there are many lessons, but one of the lessons that really stood out to me was always believe in someone and never stop believing in yourself. Albert Einstein once said, "Everybody is a genius, but if you judge a fish by its ability to climb a tree, it will live its whole life believing that it is stupid." This goes along with the lesson. Everybody is smart, but maybe smarter in some things than others. Don't judge someone and focus on one thing that they are not strong in, because you have a weak place too. In this book, you will go through Allie's life, and you will notice that Allie has trouble in school, and none of her teachers ever pay attention enough to her to realize that she needs help but is too scared to ask. But when her new teacher realizes that she is having trouble, she asks to overcome it with him. This is the same author who wrote One for the Murphys, and if you liked Wonder by R.J. Palacio, then you will most likely enjoy this book as well. Check out Fisher Tree in the school library. I hope you can't put this book down as it was for me. And my next book is A Dog's Purpose. This is Aiden's book review. A Dog's Purpose. The genre is realistic fiction with a hint of fantasy. He thinks that the author wrote this book to tell a dog's purpose on this planet. The dogs in this book's names are Bailey, Ellie, Tino, and Buddy. The owners are also a big part, so you'll get to know most of those people. The dogs want to find their purpose in life, so read A Dog's Purpose so that you can figure out what their purpose is.
That was great.
Bye, Huskies!